My name is Desmond Miles. I'm a prisoner of war. A war I never knew existed. Waged by two groups I never thought were real. Templars and assassins. The animus showed me the truth. The things I've seen, the things I've been. 1,000 years of history flowing through my veins, brought to life by this machine. They're using it. Using me to search for something. Call it the apple. It's an artifact, one of many so-called pieces of Eden. The Templars collect them. It's how they stay in power. And if the Templars get their hands on another one, everything will change. They want to make us all their slaves. When they first brought me here, I was afraid of what would happen if I tried to fight back. Now? Now I'm afraid of what will happen if I don't. My name is Desmond Miles, and this is my story.
You okay?
I told you he'd be fine.
Bastards!
Now, I just saved your life.
Saved my life? You kidnapped me! You strapped me into that thing!
Animus. It's an animus.
I don't even know you people! Why are you doing this to me?
You have information we need, Mr. Miles.
Information? I'm a bartender, for Christ's sakes! What do you want me to do, teach you how to mix a martini?
We know who you are, what you are.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't play coy with me. There isn't time. You're an assassin. And whether you realize it or not, you've got something that my employers want. Locked away in that head of yours.
But I'm not an assassin. Not anymore.
Yes, your file indicated as much. Something about an escape. Most fortunate for us.
What do you want from me?
For you to do as you're told. The animus will allow us to locate what we need. Once we have it, you'll be free to go.
I am not going back in there.
Then we'll induce a coma and continue our work. When we're done, you'll be left to die. Truth be told, the only reason you're still conscious is because this approach saves us time.
You're insane.
So what is it, Mr. Miles? Live or die? Lie down. A wise decision.
Whoa. Where am I?
You're inside the Animus.
Which is...
It's a projector that renders genetic memories in three dimensions.
Genetic memory?
Seems you'll need a bit of a tutorial. Very well. We'll start simple. What is a memory, Mr. Miles?
It's the recollection of a past event.
Specific to the individual remembering the event.
Yeah, sure.
What if I told you that the human body not only housed an individual's memory, but the memories of his ancestors as well? Genetic memory, if you will. Migration, hibernation, reproduction. How do animals know when and where to go? What to do?
That's just animal instinct.
Now you're arguing semantics, Mr. Miles. Whatever you call it, the fact remains. These creatures hold knowledge absent the requisite first-hand experience. I've spent the past 30 years trying to understand why. I discovered something most fascinating. Our DNA functions as an archive. It contains not only genetic instructions passed down from previous generations, but memories as well. The memories of our ancestors.
And the Animus lets you decode and read these DNA files.
Precisely.
But there's a problem. This is the specific memory we're trying to access. Unfortunately, when we try and open the memory, your mind withdraws. You lack the confidence to step into your ancestor's body. That's what happened earlier. You got knocked out of the target memory and pushed back to a more stable state.
Why?
It's your subconscious. It's resisting. We've found similar reactions among patients who undergo hypnosis to relive traumatic events. They can't jump directly into the specific memory. They need to be eased in. Even then, there can be problems.
So how do we fix it?
We find a memory you can synchronize with, and we move forward from there. You'll get used to it. This is the closest we can get, so it's where we'll have to start. I'm uploading the tutorial program now.
He's experiencing a far better adoption rate than the other subjects.
I'm still pulling him out. He's been in there way too long.
No, not yet. We're still so far from where we need to be.
We shouldn't risk it.
What's another hour or two?
Why don't we discuss this in the conference room? Give Desmond a minute to stretch his legs.
I really don't see the need.
Warren, please.
Fine.
We're done for today, Mr. Miles. I suggest you return to your room and get some rest.
Damn it, they locked the door. Gotta say, that's a little creepy, Doc. Waking up to you standing over me. You been watching me sleep?
We're always watching you. Now get up. We've got a lot of work to do.
Ooh, wonder who I get to kill today.
Don't be so cavalier. Your ancestors almost had the right idea, Mr. Miles. If the deaths of a few people, evil people, no less, could save the lives of thousands more, well, it seems a small sacrifice.
What do you mean, almost?
They didn't go far enough. To use a rather tired analogy, corruption is no different than cancer. Cut out the tumors, but fail to treat the source and... well, you're buying time at best. There's no true change to be had without comprehensive, systemic intervention.
Chemo for the masses.
Education. Re-education, to be more precise. But it's not easy, and it doesn't always take.
Let me guess. You've got a better solution. What is it, then?
Now that would be telling. Out of the machine, Mr. Miles.
What's the matter, Doc?
Miss Stillman is once again insisting I let you rest.
So, feel like telling me who put the stick up his ass?
We have a deadline. 1 week. Well, 6 days now.
Deadline?
I can't talk about it.
Man, put yourself in my shoes. I'm being held hostage by a group of scientists, at least I think you're scientists, and forced to spend all day in some crazy-ass machine. You won't tell me what you're looking for or why you want it, but I'm supposed to be thanking you for keeping me alive. This is so fucked! Sorry, but it is.
What do you want me to do?
Let's see, I don't know. Maybe give me some answers?
I can't. And it's better this way. Safer.
Safer for who?
Both of us.
Hey, you know what? I've got a question I think you can actually answer.
What's up?
Why is it that sometimes the guys in there talk like they're from the future?
The future?
I mean the present. Now, today, whatever.
You've probably noticed that English has become the official language of the Holy Land.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
The Animus is translating speech it deems vital into more modern English, so expect a few anachronisms. I could probably make it more authentic, but... You ever read Chaucer?
Who?
Yeah, definitely not for you.
Can you tell me more about Abstergo? What goes on here? Beyond the whole keeping me prisoner thing.
Abstergo is one of the largest pharmaceutical companies in the world. Their primary focus is antidepressants. There's some information on the computer over there.
But you already said this isn't about testing a drug. So what's the deal?
I don't like where this is going.
So it's safe to assume the Animus is not a part of their public face.
What, you haven't seen the commercials?
Oh my god. She has a sense of humor.
I'm sorry, Desmond. I've got a lot of work to do. Like I said, if you want to know more about the company, take a look at the computer. The telecommunication stuff is particularly interesting.
Let's go, Mr. Miles. Time's wasting.
Where's Lucy?
Oh, don't worry. She'll be with us soon enough.
So why are you doing all this, Doc? What are you hoping to accomplish?
You turn the television on lately? Read the newspaper?
Never cared much for that stuff.
Then, let me sum it up for you. The world's a mess. It's pathetic, really. You've seen it firsthand yourself. 1,000 years between you and your ancestor, and society remains just as barbaric, just as stupid.
And your point is...
Order, Mr. Miles. The world needs order. That is what we're working towards, and that is what you're helping us to achieve.
You expect me to believe you're building a better tomorrow?
That's exactly what we're doing. The human race calls out for direction. They want to know why they're here, what they're meant to do. Well, we're going to tell them. And once they understand how to live their lives, everything will be better.
Better how?
An end to all conflicts, large and small. Isn't that what you assassins strive for? Peace in all things?
I told you, I'm not an assassin.
Right, right.
I still don't see where I fit into things.
In time, Mr. Miles. In time, you'll understand. Or you won't. I don't care either way, as long as you show us where it is.
Where what is?
Sorry, I'm late. Ready to go?
Yes, we are.
I'm getting weird temperature readings. I think the Animus is overheating.
Christ, it's always something! How long?
Too soon to tell.
These delays are unacceptable, Miss Stillman. I want progress reports every hour.
It's gonna be a while, Desmond. Why don't you go lie down or something? Get some rest.
Why is he always yelling at you? It's his machine.
His theories. He's not the one who built it.
Who did? You?
No. Abstergo has a team of engineers. Not much they don't have. But I did oversee the assembly. Guess that's why he gets so angry with me.
He's a dick.
He's under a lot of pressure. We all are.
I can't believe you're defending the guy.
Warren saved my life, so if he wants to yell a little, let him.
What do you mean he saved your life?
You're not the only one who doesn't get to go home at night.
Wait, are you saying you're a prisoner?
When they first approached me, I was finishing up my PhD. The university had made it clear I had no future there. They didn't like the subject of my doctorate, called it pseudoscience. Said keeping me on would discredit and embarrass them. It was the same everywhere. Other universities, companies I interviewed with. Pretty soon I was out of money and out of time. I was this close to waiting tables. Then I got a letter.
From Vidic?
He said he'd been following my career since undergrad, that he believed in my work and wanted to meet to discuss my future. You have no idea how good it felt to hear that. So I met with him. What did I have to lose?
And he offered you a job?
Yes, here at Abstergo, helping out on the Animus project. I'd have a chance to test my theories and prove the professor's wrong. How could I turn that down?
I think I'm missing the part where you became a prisoner.
Sometimes I wonder if they weren't behind it all. If they manipulated events so that I'd get desperate. They can do that. They can do anything. I didn't think when I agreed to come here. They even told me I'd be trapped. For 6 months, a year max. Once the product launched, there'd be no need for secrecy anymore. But until then, I'd be a guest of the company. At least, that's what they said.
And when the Animus was ready?
They came in while I was sleeping. Three guys. Guns. They dragged me out of bed. God. The worst part is I knew them. One guy, Richard, we ate lunch together sometimes. And now he was gonna... They were cracking jokes. I tried to pull away. He hit me. And that's when he told me I was going to die.
Christ, what did you do?
Nothing. I kept telling myself it wasn't real. And then Warren was there, shouting at them to get away from me. And they listened.
Jesus.
He's not a happy man, Desmond. I wouldn't even say he's a good man, but he saved my life. They never came for me again. And he promised they never would.
You're still stuck here working for these nutjobs.
But I'm alive. Anyway, I really do need to get the Animus repaired. I'll see you tomorrow, Desmond.
What the hell? Someone's been in here. Looks like some kind of access code.
Rise and shine. We've got quite a day ahead of us.
You're in a good mood this morning.
Miss Stillman has made some modifications to the Animus. You should be able to remain inside even longer now.
And help you with your treasure hunt.
This is serious business, Mr. Miles. I don't think you fully appreciate the work that Abstergo does.
Maybe because I don't actually know what you people do.
We change the world. Every day, in 100 different ways. Did you know that nearly every single breakthrough of the past millennia, be it medical, mechanical, or philosophical, has come from Abstergo or its predecessors?
That's a bold claim, Doc. Think you might be exaggerating a bit?
Not in the slightest. Oh, we certainly don't take the credit. That would arouse far too much suspicion. We choose our beneficiaries with great care.
Why?
Isn't it obvious? It means we're in control.
But how? What makes you guys so special, so smart, that you happen to invent all these things while us mere mortals stumble around like idiots?
To be fair, we don't invent them. We find them.
Find them?
They're gifts, Mr. Miles. From those who came before. We'll have to continue this discussion later. Time's wasting.
Morning, Desmond.
Yeah. Hi. We done already?
Get up.
I
Whatever you say, Doc.
I'm ending the session. I'll be right there. You're sure about this? Yes. No. Everything's Denver. I don't see how he could... Of course. I understand. You're in a lot of trouble, Mr. Miles.
What's his problem?
They're coming for you.
Who's coming for me?
Assassins.
Hey, I had nothing to do with this.
Sounds like they're mounting some kind of rescue attempt. Guess you're more important than you realized.
Man, things just keep getting weirder and weirder around here.
It was bound to happen.
What do you mean?
That little fight your ancestor started during the Third Crusade? It never ended. You're being held by Templars.
Vidic's a Templar?
There's no way you could have known. They hide it so well. But to answer your question, Vidic works for them. We all do. Abstergo is their company.
I thought Templars were old dudes with funny hats who sat around drinking beer and plotting world domination with, like, the lizard people.
No. Except the part about world domination, I guess. Look, Desmond, it's complicated. Half the stuff they say about the Templars comes from crazy tinfoil hat-wearing nutjobs. The other half is misinformation intentionally produced by the Templars themselves.
But they are the bad guys, right?
If there's one thing I've learned since I started working here, it's that there's no such thing. It's all so relative. I guess the best way to explain it is, what they want is good, but the way they're going about it, it's bad. Really bad.
What are they trying to do? Lucy.
Yes.
Miss Dillon, I need to speak with you. Get up here, now.
On my way, Doctor. I'm sorry, Desmond, I have to go. You should turn in for the night. The answers to all of your questions are right in front of you. You just have to know where to look.
Missed you this morning, Doc.
Get in the Animus. Understand there's a narrow launch window.
Wherever it's hidden, time to retrieve it.
Working on it.
And when it's done,
he'll be taken care of.
I want that progress report by tomorrow morning.
I've got some work I need to do. So you've got the rest of the night to yourself.
I think there's a problem with the Animus.
Nope, it's working fine.
I'm pretty sure it just ejected me
I'm pretty sure you should shut up.
You ready to finally tell me what's going on?
We have to stop them, Desmond. When they access that last memory of yours, they're just getting started. They want to change everything. The way we live, the way we think, the way we are. You've gotten the lecture from Vidic about what's wrong with the world, how we need order and discipline, so they're going to give it to us. Only we don't have a say in the matter.
How?
The Templar treasure. They think it...
Miss Stillman?
I'm here.
I need you to upload Desmond's files to the database.
Got it.
So what? You're using me to find this Templar treasure? What do they call it? The Peace of Eden?
Yes.
Well, it's looking like it's at Messiah, so I don't know why they're wasting all this time with me. Why don't they just send their people to pick it up?
They can't. It's not that simple. The artifact from Messiah, they had it. It was destroyed in the accident.
Then what are they hoping for me? You know, for my ancestor, to tell them?
They're hoping he'll show them where the other ones are.
You mean there's more than one of these things?
Oh, Desmond, you have no idea.
Is there a problem, Miss
Stillman? No, Warren. Everything's Denver on my end.
Then, where are the files?
I've got to move these files before he gets suspicious. We'll talk more later.
Wait, what's that mean, everything's Denver?
It means everything's fine.
Why Denver?
It's a reference to Denver International Airport. There's an underground facility there. It's where the accident happened.
Time's wasting, Mr. Miles.
Yeah, I'm coming.
We're nearly done, you know.
And then what?
You'll see. Maybe they'll even let you watch when it begins. It's not as terrible as you think.
Look, I know you're not gonna let me leave. So why not tell me what's going on? Humor me.
I'm not an idiot, Mr. Miles. I think you've already learned quite a bit.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Of course not.
All right, let me ask you something else then.
Yes?
Some of the stuff I'm seeing in the Animus, sometimes it seems wrong. Untrue, like the history is off somehow. It doesn't...
It doesn't what, Mr. Miles? Match up with what you read on an online encyclopedia? What your high school history teacher taught you? Let me ask you something. Do these supposed experts have access to secret knowledge kept hidden from the rest of us?
There are books. Letters, documents, all sorts of source material from back then. Some of it seems to contradict what the Animus is showing me.
Anyone can write a book, and they can put whatever they want on its pages. Anything. Used to be, we thought the world was flat.
Some people still do.
Yes, and they publish books about it. Or that the moon landing was a hoax. I believe there's also a book claims the world was created in 7 days. A bestseller, too.
Where's this going, Doc?
The point, I suppose, is that you shouldn't trust everything you hear, everything you read. What's that your ancestors said? Nothing is true?
Everything is permitted.
Yes, exactly. It's part of what makes the Animus so spectacular. There's no room for misinterpretation.
There's always room.
Touché, Mr. Miles. Now that I've answered your question, can we begin? I said get up, goddammit! Listen!
Oh no.
Seems your assassin friends found us.
What?
How'd you do it, Desmond?
Hey, look, I don't know what you're talking about, but whatever's going on down there has got nothing to do with me.
They're here for you, and I sure as shit didn't invite them. What's the situation down there?
We're taking heavy fire.
Can you contain it, or do I need to evacuate the prisoner?
Five or six. We've got them outnumbered. Couple of wounded, but we'll pull through. We'll get it under control.
God damn you, Desmond. You couldn't leave well enough alone.
I told you I had nothing to do with this. How would I even contact them? Telepathy? Come on!
Doesn't matter. They'll be dead soon enough. Here, have a listen.
That's been neutralized.
Looks like the cavalry won't be coming.
Dunno, Doc. We're freaking out a minute ago. Your little research facility not as secure as you thought it was? Worried they'll be back with more?
I don't think so, Desmond.
What Lucy here is trying to say is that there aren't any assassins left to come for you. We've been very busy this past year, hunting down your little enclaves, your desert communes and whatnot. I'm afraid you're on your own. Rest up, Mr. Miles. Tomorrow, we finish this.
I'm sorry, Desmond.
You mentioned the desert. Do you think...
They sent a team there, but the place was deserted. I don't know where your parents are, and I can't promise they're still alive. But I think they got away.
Thanks. Thanks for checking.
It's not as bad as it seems.
What are you talking about? They just killed, literally killed, my only chance of getting out of here. And then I find out the assassins are all but destroyed, and Christ, I still don't know what these people are planning. But I do know they plan to kill me when they're done. I am screwed, okay? What do you want me to do?
Just try and have a little faith. Have faith. Rest up, Desmond. You're gonna need the energy.
Get up.
Even earlier than usual, Doc.
I'd like to get this over with as quickly as possible.
If you say so.
Don't be so glum, Mr. Miles. Today is a historic day. One that will be remembered for years to come. Remembered by some of us, anyway.
What the hell was that?
Well?
We've got the map.
How many?
At least half a dozen.
We don't need them all.
We should assume some amount of decay. I can't imagine they'll all still be functioning. At least two appear to reside on land masses that no longer exist.
We'll dispatch teams to each site and determine viability. We only need one, after all.
What about the rest?
Collect them. Let's not leave anything to chance. Last thing we need is some damn survivor making trouble for us in the new world.
And the assassin?
We have what we need. Kill him.
Wait. You know how these things work. I doubt we'll be able to walk right in.
What's your point?
We might need him. His memories. I'd recommend we hold him until we have confirmation that there aren't any surprises waiting for us at the sites.
This is a waste of time.
You said it yourself. We shouldn't leave anything to chance.
Very well. Sure, we have no further need of him, then kill him.
Fine. Stop undermining my authority!
I just saved your ass.
Let's go. We've got a lot of work to do. Don't get too comfortable, Mr. Miles. We'll be back for you soon enough.
What the hell is that? Keeping here before me. And what happened to him? What? What does it mean, I wonder?
We have to go.
Lucy, where have you been? Why did they...
Now! Get in.
What's with the blood? Are you okay?
Look, we have maybe 10 minutes, maybe, before they figure out what I've done. If we're not out of here and on the road before then...
Wait, we're leaving?
Desmond, I promise I'll answer all of your questions later. But right now, I need you to just shut up and do what I say. So please, get in the Animus.
All right.
Get up. Let's go.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna need a second.
There isn't time, Desmond. We have to leave. Stay close.
Hey! You're not supposed to be up here! Open this door!
I'm calling it in.
We have a breach in the research wing. I repeat, there's been a breach in the research wing.
Nice walls. Fancy.
There they are! Don't let them get away! Oh. Holy shit! Look at this place.
What about the cameras?
I rigged them to loop old footage. How do you think I managed to hide all your nighttime snooping from Abstergo?
You're good.
So I've been told. But they're on to us now. We need to hurry. Careful. We need to get to that elevator on the other side of the room. Follow my lead. But keep an eye out for security. I'd rather avoid a fight.
Is that an animus?
Hold on.
What the? How many of them are there?
Wait.
Is it animuses? Animi? What do you think, Lucy? Lucy, what do they need with all of them?
Desmond. Fuck. I thought this card would work. It must be on a separate system, and I don't have the code.
Wait.
How did you do that?
I don't know.
Let's go. It's always something.
What was that in the Animus? Subject 16? Ezio, Audi something?
I think we've been wrong all along. That's why we need to get out of here. Vidic and the Templars, they're only part of the problem.
What do you mean?
I'll explain when we get there.
Get where?
Get in.
You're joking.
It's for your own protection.
Oh, man.
We're almost there.
Thanks for that. It was great. Shoving the trunk, bouncing around. Love
this
it.
Way.
So, gonna tell me what's going on now?
There was a reason for the escape, Desmond.
Figures.
We need your help.
For what? Another treasure hunt through time?
Abstergo's gonna replace their Apple of Eden. The map your ancestor found guarantees it. The other assassins, they'll do what they can, where they can, but...
What? What is it?
We're losing this war, Desmond. The Templars are too powerful. And every day, more of us die.
I still don't see how I fit into things.
We're going to train you. Turn you into one of us.
What? No. No, you've seen me in action. I'm no good at this, and even if I was, it would take months. Years, even.
No. Not with the animus. Not with the bleeding effect.
But I'm just one guy.
Sometimes, that's all you need.
So that's why you found him. My ancestor. What was his name? Ezio?
If you can follow in his footsteps, you'll learn everything he did, just like he did. Years of training, absorbed in a matter of days.
You broke me out of Abstergo and brought me here just to make me an assassin?
Look, there's more to it than that, but it'll have to wait. Trust me, okay?
All right, I'm in. Tell me what you need.
Really? You're sure?
I thought you'd be happy about this.
Sorry, I'm just a little surprised. I spent the whole ride over here figuring out how I was gonna convince you to do this.
Save it. After what those Templar bastards put me through, I'm ready, willing, and able.
Thank you.
Lucy! You made it! God, it's been so long. 7 years, can you believe it?
Indeed. Welcome back. Ah, so this must be the infamous Subject 17. Desmond Miles, was it?
Who are you?
I'm sorry, where are my manners? I'm Sean Hastings. This is Rebecca Crane.
Nice to meet you, Desmond.
Right, well, it's been lovely chatting, but if you don't mind, Desmond, it's best we get straight to work. Time is precious. Doubly so these days.
We've got everything set up and ready, Lucy. Just say the word and we'll get going.
Here, I brought you something. A parting gift from Abstergo.
Whoa! The memory core! This is amazing! With their data, things are gonna go a lot faster. I'll get to work on merging the code.
Hey, listen. I just wanted to say thank you. And that I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Yeah, you know, before. Everything at Abstergo. It was just... I wasn't ready.
It's okay.
No. Going through all that. Knowing that the Templars still exist, what they're planning.
What's done is done, Desmond. You're here now, and that's what matters.
Lucy, I've been seeing things. Symbols in my bedroom. The code on the keypad. Just like Altair.
It's from the bleeding effect. You're taking on more than your ancestors' memories. You're taking on their skills, too. In this case, Eagle Vision.
Skills?
You're more receptive now. So if all goes well, everything Ezio learns in the Animus, you'll learn too.
You really think this will work? That I'll become an assassin?
You already are an assassin. You'll just be better at it.
Yeah, hopefully much better at it. I mean, seriously, I saw the tapes from Abstergo. You didn't even try and escape.
What a dick. What's all this stuff for?
This stuff, Desmond. Oh, this stuff is nothing special, really, this stuff. It's just the stuff that keeps our entire operation from falling apart, really. It requires a great deal of concentration to keep it all moving, so you'll forgive me if I don't have time to play meet and greet.
Sean's in charge of maintaining our knowledge archives. It's like a digital library. He'll be riding shotgun with me while you're in the Animus. So if you come across anything of note, people, places, events, etc., he'll create database entries you can consult for additional information.
Yeah, it's not just databases, though. I also provide tactical support for the other assassins. You know, Desmond, the ones who are out there, actually doing stuff, risking their lives, little things like that.
Hey, Desmond. What's up?
Just wondering what your role is in all this.
I take care of Baby. It's my job to keep her up and running.
Baby? You mean the Animus?
Actually, I prefer Animus 2.0, since Baby's twice as awesome as anything you'll find at Abstergo. The Templars might have deeper pockets than us, but they've got no ambition, no passion, no competitive edge. That's why, even with all their resources, anything they can do, I can do better. Faster, too. Anyway, take a seat when you're ready, and we can get started. I just need to make a few more adjustments.
So how does this work? Of course.
Deep breath.
Ah! Oh, what are you, a tiny child?
Sean!
Well...
Here we go.
Everything all right?
Better than all right. You're making amazing progress.
Amazing's quite a strong word.
Then why are we stopping?
Prolonged exposure to the animus can have, side effects.
Awesome.
It's nothing to worry about. You haven't shown any of the symptoms.
Symptoms? What symptoms?
Degradation of cognition, temporal hallucinations, multiple awareness issues, overlapping realities, you know.
So what you're saying is...
What we're saying, Desmond, is if you're not careful, you may not need the animus to visit with your ancestors, which wouldn't be a bad thing, assuming you could control it. Up until now, though, no one has.
Subject 16.
We have safeguards, Desmond. And they kept him in the animus for way too long, sometimes days at a time. We're being careful with you.
I hope so.
Anyway, I was hoping we could test out your skill retention. See if you've picked up some of Ezio's abilities.
I'm game.
Great. Meet me downstairs when you're ready.
Hey, nice work today. You're a natural.
Thanks. It's definitely getting easier. I gotta say, after all the crap I went through at Abstergo, it's nice to be with the good guys.
Good guys? Let's not get carried away.
What's that supposed to mean?
In case you've forgotten, Rebecca, we're assassins. I can look it up for you if you like. Basically, it means we assassinate people.
Only when we have to.
It's a choice. You're choosing to kill.
I haven't killed anyone.
No, not yet. But what do you think all this is for, eh? You think Lucy is giving you Ezio's abilities so you can build schools in South America and deliver rice to starving Indonesians? What are you, Desmond, a vegan? You'd be the first vegan assassin in history.
Look, it's not ideal. And taking a life is never easy. But sometimes, there's no other way. Sometimes, Desmond, people have to die for things to change.
She's got a point. But don't fool yourself into thinking you have no say. I mean, isn't that what we're all about here? Safeguarding free will?
Sorry, I didn't mean to make it into a whole big thing.
That's cool. So, how's she treating you?
The translation software is still a bit laggy. You're probably catching the odd bit of Italian. Sorry about that.
No worries. Abstergo's machine wasn't perfect either. And the subtitles? Definitely a big plus. What could 16 have found that needs so much secrecy and security?
Well, I don't know, do I? Lucy thinks it's something about the Codex, but I'm not so sure. I'm all ears if it's as life-changing as 16 says. Blimey, if I was allowed to use the Animus, I'd be the one in there finding out. Instead, as usual, I'm forced to sit here on the sidelines.
What are you up to?
What am I up to? Who are you, my mum? I've been running traces on the Codex pages. Looking to see if any of them are still around.
And?
Nothing concrete. Reports of one in the archives of the National Central Library in Florence. Maybe a few in the hands of collectors. Probably Templars. I'd send someone to check it out, but we're very short on manpower.
How do you think the Codex wound up in Italy? I mean, it seems so random.
Dante Alighieri by way of Marco Polo.
Seriously?
Something happened in 1321, yeah? Now, I'm still working on making the connections, but from what I can tell, Polo encountered the assassins while visiting Kublai Khan. This must be when he obtained the Codex. Now, when he returned to Italy, he passed it on to Dante. Dante was close to him, if not an assassin himself. Now, I've no idea what brought the two of them together, but I'll tell you what, I reckon we could find out.
I don't think Lucy wants us messing with the Animus.
Yeah, you're right. We've got enough to deal with. I guess satisfying my curiosity will have to wait.
So what's the plan?
We're gonna see what you've managed to retain. Come on! Abstergo's out there, looking for us. They're better funded and better equipped, so it's only a matter of time before they find this place. We need to be ready for them when they do. I want you to activate the warehouse's defense system. I'll let you figure out how to reach the sensors.
Oh, come on. Not even a hint?
Open your eyes, Desmond. All right, I think we're done for the day. You should get some rest.
Lucy, what happened to 16 wasn't your fault. You were just as much a prisoner as I was.
Thanks. Good night, Desmond. I'm glad you're here. Sorry to barge in on you like this, but it's getting late and we were... Hey, you okay?
Yeah, all good. Weird dreams, that's all.
All right. I'll let you get ready. See you in a few.
Ah, good of you to join us.
Sorry. Long night.
What a professional. What a professional approach.
Leave him alone.
Well, you'll forgive me if I want to get some actual work done. Madness, isn't it?
Sean, please, that's enough.
All right.
Hey.
Hi.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Everything's fine.
You sure?
We lost two more teams last night. That's eight more of us, just... gone.
I'm sorry.
I don't know what to do anymore. It just keeps getting worse and worse.
Hey, remember what you told me? You gotta have faith. And look, here we are, safe and sound.
For how long? And when they find us, then what?
When that happens, if that happens, we'll deal with it. I'll keep you safe.
Anyway, enough with my little breakdown. I should get back to work. And so should you.
When we were still flesh and our home still whole, your kind betrayed us. We who made you. We who gave you life. We were strong, but you were many, and both of us craved war. So busy were we with earthly concerns, we failed to notice the heavens. And by the time we did, the world burned until naught remained but ash. It should have ended then and there. But we built you in our own image. We built you to survive. And so we did. Few were our numbers. Your kind and mine. It took sacrifice, strength, compassion. But we rebuilt. And as life returned to the world, we endeavored to ensure this tragedy would not be repeated. But now, we are dying, and time will work against us. Truth turned into myth and legend. What we built, misunderstood. Let my words preserve the message and make a record of our loss. But let my words also bring hope. You must find the other temples, built by those who knew to turn away from war. They worked to protect us. To save us from the fire. If you can find them, if their work can be saved, so too might this world. Be quick, for time grows short, and guard against the cross, for there are many who will stand in your way. It is done. The message is delivered. We are gone now from this world. All of us. We can do no more. The rest is up to you, Desmond.
What the fuck? There's only about 10 minutes until I
get... Need all of my equipment.
Ready to go before they do. Desmond!
Yeah.
All right, Sean, I need you and Rebecca to get everything in here packed up and loaded into the truck. You and I'll deal with the Templars.
What, they're here?
It was only a matter of time before they discovered us. To be honest, I'm surprised it took them as long as it did.
Let's go.
So, what's the plan? We ditch this place and then what?
There's another safe house. We've got company. The truck's just up ahead.
Mr. Miles, this is an unexpectedly pleasant turn of events. And here I thought I'd have to waste more men on you. kind of you to save me the trouble.
What do you want, Vidic?
For you to come home. We miss you terribly. There's still so much work for us to do together.
It's not happening, Warren.
You continue to disappoint in every conceivable way, Miss Stillman. I saved your life once, do you remember? And this is how you repay me?
You saved me so you could keep experimenting on people, destroying their lives. And for what?
Oh, this tired argument again. As I recall, you were there, at my side, every step of the way. Their blood is on your hands just as much as mine.
You need to stop him.
I'm on it. Uh-oh, Doc. Looks like it's just you and me now.
Enjoy your victory, Mr. Miles. Temporary as it is.
Desmond! We have to go!
There you are! Come on! Help Lucy into the van! Hurry, Desmond! We need to go!
You'll have your turn, Desmond. Warren's gonna get what he deserves. I promise.
So what now? Where are we headed?
There's a cabin up north. We should be safe there. At least for a little while. I have to analyze those tapes from your session. Figure out what's happening.
And then what?
Here we go. I've got you all hooked up. Got a long drive ahead of us. Figured you might want to play around with the animus on the way.
All right, but I got some questions first. I mean, what the hell was that in the vault?
What you saw proves everything I was afraid of. The Templars aren't our biggest threat. Not by a long shot.
So what, the sun is? What's it gonna do, cook the Earth?
I doubt it, but I don't know. There's been some speculation that the Earth's magnetic field is weakening. A sufficiently strong flare could flip the poles and cause a geomagnetic reversal. It's all theoretical, but if it happens, the planet could become geologically unstable. Very unstable.
It's meant to be the stuff of pseudoscience, but clearly something catastrophic happened to the people of the first civilization. And that woman, what was her name? Minerva, was it? She seemed to think we were due for a second round.
So either way, we're fucked.
I don't know yet. We'll keep reviewing the tapes. And you can keep digging through your memories. Maybe there's more to discover.
All right. Guess I better get started.
Lucy, I can't seem to get a position on Ezio's POE.
POE? Could one of you tell me what's going on?
Sorry, Desmond. Peace of Eden. In the Vatican, Minerva talked about other temples, that they're the key to preventing whatever terrible thing is about to happen to the Earth.
Right.
To find the temples, I'm convinced we need to get our hands on Ezio's Apple of Eden. Minerva altered it somehow when she touched it.
Wait, we're at the Auditore Villa.
Yes, it's our last safe house in Italy. It turns out the Templars are watching the border.
Ezio hid the POE sometime in 1507, but when I try to access that DNA sequence, he seems to be remembering something else.
Like a memory inside a memory?
Yes, exactly. Maybe.
Exactly, maybe?
I believe you experienced something similar back at Abstergo, didn't you?
Subject 15 exhibited memory within memory-like patterns, but she was pregnant. The memories of both the fetus's father and mother were competing.
Desmond's not pregnant, at least, as far as I can tell. Might just have had a big lunch.
Can you skip ahead to a later memory?
No, it doesn't work.
Well, that sounds familiar. We couldn't access Altair's later memories until Desmond had improved his synchronization.
Then it's possible something similar has occurred here. Ezio's troubled state is being transposed onto Desmond, destabilizing the memory. Either that, or Rebecca's just not a very good engineer.
Thanks, asshole.
What? I'm simply listing possible explanations. And that is amongst the most likely. Touchy.
This place isn't secure. Cell phone surveillance can see right through the walls.
Don't you mean satellite surveillance?
Are you kidding? Abstergo upgraded to cell towers ages ago. The waves go through everything above ground. They're gonna find us.
No, they aren't. Come with me.
Hey.
There's a beam blocking it from the inside. We're not getting in this way.
What's her next move?
The road just loops back into the highway. This is not a good place for us to be right now.
Do we have any tarps? We need to cover up the van.
I really hate to stress this, yeah, but we are running out of time.
Well, help us then, Sean. Do you have any ideas?
I don't know. Maybe there's another way into the sanctuary.
Hey, I think I've got something. Follow me.
Desmond, that was pretty awesome.
It just felt natural. We can get in through here.
Good job.
We'll just wait up here then, shall we? Yeah, all alone, with massive targets painted on our backs.
What was that?
I don't see anything.
Run! Get out before I soldati get you! Correte! Go!
They escaped through here.
What?
Ezio and the villagers. After the attack, I can see them now.
I know it's difficult, but try to compartmentalize, Desmond. Focus on the present.
What if I can't stop the visions? How long before I start painting symbols on the walls?
Don't joke about that. 16 is dead. We're focusing on the present, okay?
Ezio must have come back here way after the attack. But why?
Desmond!
Right. Let's open that door.
You guys did it!
About bloody time. What's that?
Looks like something Ezio left behind. There are numbers underneath it. 1419, 1420, and 1421.
Maybe you should lie down for a bit.
No, it's all right. I'm fine.
Whoa, they really built this place to last. No signs of structural damage, no cell signal either. Should be safe to set up. Let's get the animus down there.
Okay, everything's good here. Sean, hide the van in town, and make sure you aren't followed.
What? What is that smell?
It's my clothes.
They smell like you swam through a sewer.
It was Lucy's idea.
Wait a second, guys. We need power down here. There's a line running nearby I can hook into, but the wattage is weak.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah. Anything else you two would like? You know, some caviar, perhaps? Maybe you'd like me to knit you a lovely hat. No? Fine, follow me.
I'm back.
Just in time. The sun's rising.
Yes! It's booted. We're good to go.
Did you miss me? No? Anyone? Hello? Am I speaking out loud? Hello? Workaholics.
Let's get started.
Do you have any clue about those numbers under the drawing?
1419, 1420, 1421. Maybe something to do with the Hundred Years' War. Or wait, in 1419, Pope Martin V arrived in Florence, right? He left for Rome in 1420, and that was the same year Brunelleschi began building the Duomo. And in 1421... In 1421... Yeah, I'll have to do some more research, I think.
So, what do you think of Monteriggioni?
This is not Monteriggioni. Monteriggioni existed in the Renaissance. Ask me how the town was in 1554 when it was seized by Florence, and I'll tell you.
Huh. I figured you'd like it nowadays. Seems not to have changed much.
Exactly. History is the study of change. Change is life. things become static, it means they're dead.
What are we gonna do about Abstergo?
Wait it out. As soon as we find the Apple, I get in contact with our other teams in Europe, but as far as Italy goes, we're on our own.
It'd be nice to have some help from above.
Our top assassins are busy gathering info about the Templar satellite launch. We've pinpointed several possible facilities in the US, China, and Russia, but there are no clear leads yet.
What are the other teams doing?
Combating Abstergo's search for pieces of Eden. As far as I know, Abstergo has no clue about the temple's and Ezio's apple. We might actually be ahead for once.
You seem focused.
I've been busy patching new systems into Baby here. She's only gonna get better.
Is Desmond gonna be able to relive memories this time?
As a matter of fact, he will.
Always a tech geek?
Nah, I was into sports, but then I broke my leg and started playing with computers. Who knew that coding could be just as exhilarating as strapping on a board and dropping out of a helicopter?
Just FYI, you might want to get your adrenal glands checked. You know? Because that is not normal.
We've got it. Colosseum.
Let's go. We can be there before dawn.
Wait, there was something about that door. I don't think I saw a handle. Let me run an analysis.
Great. So we need some kind of futuristic key.
It seems to open with a verbally triggered mechanism. I've never seen anything like it.
You mean it needs a password?
Try humming Beethoven's Fifth.
Damn European power grid. Now we can't scan Ezio's memories to find the password.
Hey, maybe it has something to do with this.
The symbol matches the one on the door to the vault.
1419, 1420, 1421. What if they aren't dates?
1419, 1420. Oh my God.
What?
God.
Tell us already!
I am! The Tetragrammaton, the 72 names of God! You see? They're all contained within three verses, Exodus 19 through 21. And get this, you'll like this, if you arrange the four Hebrew letters in God's name within an equilateral triangle, their numerical values add up to the same number. 72!
Are you absolutely sure about this?
That's kind of why I'm saying it out loud, Rebecca, yeah, but I haven't got to the kicker yet. Construction on the Colosseum began in the year 72.
I think we have our password.
Sean, go get the van.
Deja vu.
I bet.
Let's go.
Whoa, what about us, eh? You might actually need a historian down there.
Sean's right. That tunnel should lead under Capitoline Hill. I'll help them find another entrance. Be careful, Desmond.
I'll drive.
Ah, yeah, nice try. I've seen your car.
To this space, the epilogue of our ending. Let it be found by he who is deemed worthy. Let it guide him. Let it shape his path forward. Let it save the world we leave behind.
Who are you?
In the beginning, we set our truths to parchment, to stone, to the memory of men. These proved impermanent things. Cleansed by fire, cleansed by famine, cleansed by flood. All the world is innocent once more. Innocent and ignorant.
I'm coming.
Took you long enough.
What is this place?
Santa Maria alla Quelli. See those columns along the aisles? They're lifted from Roman ruins. Now, supposedly, this church was built on top of the ancient temple of Juno.
I like the ceiling.
Do you? You like the ceiling? Oh, you are a fascinating traveling companion.
Goes.
Stamina, unending. We cannot evade his grasp. Not forever.
Hello. That wasn't in the blueprints.
Desmond, get down here!
On my way.
Whatever this is, it doesn't do anything. It's a dead end.
I'm not so sure.
Kill us, mate. You're gonna have to try a little harder than that.
We're here.
Now for that password. Sean's right, that is.
I'm always right.
About that dead end.
That never happened. I was misquoted.
Think it speaks English?
Just say it.
Okay. 72.
The apple seems to be in the center.
Time to find out where those temples are. We did it.
I can't believe it.
So where are the temples?
You want me to ask it?
Or think it or something. Sure you asked it the right thing?
I know this. I know that symbol. That's a Phrygian cap. It stands for freedom. And that's a Masonic eye. Now those two come together in only one way.
What's happening? I can't move.
Your DNA communes with the apple. You have activated it.
Let me go!
On the 72nd day before the moment of awakening, you... birthed from our loins and the loins of our enemies. The end and the beginning, who we abhor and honor. The final journey commences. There is one who would accompany you through the gate. She lies not within our sight. The cross darkens the horizon.
What are you doing?
The path must be opened. You cannot escape your part in this. The scales shall be balanced.
Stop! Please!
You know very little. We must guide you. Cease your struggle.
Thank you. No!
It is done. The way lies all before you. Only she remains to be found. Awaken the sixth. Go, alone!
We can keep him like this for a few days, maybe a week.
Call ahead. Tell him we're on our way.
As soon as we're clear. Okay, I shut down the Animus monitoring system to free up a lot of memory, but even like this, it's still risky.
Desmond will be fine. The partition worked, the Animus is stable, and his signs are good.
For now. But this was built to recreate memories, not simulate entire cognitive processes.
The Animus will do its part, and Desmond will do the rest.
What's happening? I can't move. I can't.
No!
Just walk right past me.
16?
No, they didn't tell you my name.
Oh, God damn it, I'm still in the Animus?
Quite a shock you suffered out there.
Rebecca! Get me out of here.
They can't help you, Desmond. You're a broken man. Your mind, it's... broken.
Broken? I feel fine.
So did I.
Hey!
Look at me now! Let's talk, buddy.
What is this place?
It's nice, isn't it? We're in the guts of the Animus. The original test program. No memories here, just basic physics, weather simulations. Hello, world. You're lucky someone up there had the sense to plug you in here. It saved your life.
Saved it from what?
Right now, you should be sitting in a hospital ward, drooling and chewing on your tongue. For now, the Animus is keeping you intact. Keeping all your ancestors from collapsing into one big mess. But if you can't find a sync nexus, all those personalities will smash together. And that won't be pretty.
A sync nexus?
I'm getting there. Hold on. There. That thing is your way out.
You're screwing with me.
Here's the problem. Your brain is hash. Too many ghosts in your head, too many voices. So how do you fix that? You claw your way back into the stored data, you find unfinished memories, and you crack them open. Finish what you started until your ancestor has nothing left to show you. That is a sync nexus. And when you find it, the Animus can separate Desmond from Ezio and Altair and send you home, back to your body.
How do you know all this?
Because it happened to me. But my body, it's worm food now. So I'm stuck here. A word of warning? When you step through there, everything changes. Nothing feels normal. But you are still in control, and it's up to you to find your way out.
Right.
If you hurry, you might make it back in time for Lucy's funeral.
What?
Ah! Oh, I thought you knew.
Lucy. Oh, God. I'm so sorry. Wasn't me. Wasn't me. It was that voice. Juno. She took hold of me. She made me.
Done.
hell just happened?
You were snooping. Wandering outside the Desmond partition. So once the Animus located you, it pulled you back here. It's just following orders. Like a fail-safe program. Trying to keep your poor head intact, whether you like it or not.
What are you doing here exactly?
Playing. Learning. Waiting. A lot of waiting. I keep the Animus distracted as best I can. For you, so you can explore. Otherwise, it might hunt you down like a little virus and, delete you.
Well, my guardian angel.
There's no such thing.
Yeah, I... Thanks. 16?
Desmond, think about this. What if I went with you?
With me? Where?
It could work. Just for a while. Until I found a way out. Another body, maybe, or a... I don't know. I don't want to be here anymore.
That's not going to happen. I'm sorry.
No. I guess I had my chance. And I wasted it. Do you regret anything, Desmond?
Like what?
Running away? Leaving your parents behind? Finding a shit job and pretending to be productive? What's it like spending your whole life avoiding hard decisions?
Come on.
Sure, you're an assassin. But it wasn't your choice.
Do you have a point?
I want to know. If you regret anything.
Sure. I wish I'd been more patient with my parents. I wish I'd listened. And Lucy. Maybe things could have been different if I'd... I'm not sure.
Thank you.
For what?
For making sense.
Here it comes!
What is that? What's going on?
This is the end, Desmond. Scheduled for deletion.
What are you doing?
What is a man but the sum of his memories? We are the stories we live, the tales we tell ourselves.
Don't do this!
I'm saving you, idiot! Go! Go!
Desmond?
He's talking to me?
I heard your name once before, Desmond. A long time ago. And now it lingers in my mind, like an image from an old dream. I do not know where you are, or by what means you can hear me. But I know you are listening. I have lived my life as best I could, not knowing its purpose, but drawn forward like a moth to a distant moon. And here at last, I discover a strange truth. That I am only a conduit for a message that eludes my understanding. Who are we who have been so blessed to share our stories like this? To speak across centuries? Maybe you will answer all the questions I have asked. Maybe you will be the one to make all this suffering worth something in the end. Now, listen.
A strange place, this nexus of time. I am not used to the calculations. That has always been Minerva's domain. I see you still have many questions. Who were we? What became of us? What do we desire of you? You will have your answers. Only listen, and I will tell you how. Both before the end and after, we sought to save the world. We built vaults within which to work, each dedicated to a different method of salvation. They were placed underground to avoid the war which raged above, and also as a precaution should we fail in our efforts. Each vault's knowledge was transmitted to a single place. It was our duty, mine, Minerva's, and Juno's, to sort and sample all that was collected. We chose those solutions which held the most promise and devoted ourselves to testing their merits. Six we tried in succession, each more encouraging than the last, but none worked. And then the world ended. The earth shook for days, the fires burned for weeks, and when the ash had settled, less than 10,000 of your kind still lived, and far fewer of ours. But we carried on, together, to rebuild, to renew. Listen, you must go there, to the place where we labored and lost. Take my words, pass them from your head into your hands. That is how you will open the way. But be warned, much still remains in flux, and I do not know how things will end, either in my time or yours.
Wait, look, his vitals are stabilizing. Something's happening. He's moving.
Desmond. Can you hear me? Son?
I know what we need to do.
Let's go.
In another moment, down went Alice after it, never once considering how in the world she was to get out again.
You all saw that, right?
Wow.
Wow indeed.
The key must be the amulet Haytham took from London.
We might know what it looks like, but we're no closer to finding it. Desmond, you need to keep going.
Hey, he's your ancestor too. Why don't you hop in the animus?
Really? That's your response? It's like dealing with a six-year-old. What is wrong with you, Desmond?
You want to know what's wrong? I'm sick of being treated like I'm not even here. Desmond, do this. Desmond, do that. Desmond, you better figure things out because the sun is going to turn us all to ash. And I know I was really nice to you, but actually I'm just another Templar plot twist. And yes, I would like very much for you to be controlled by a magic space wizard so that you can murder me. So there's your answer. I'm sick of being a goddamn pawn. I thought it might be different with you. I mean, you're my father, but it turns out you're no better than the fucking Templars.
Don't you ever equate me to those bastards again. You hear me? Everything I do, everything I have done, has been for you. Maybe I pushed a little too hard, asked a little too much, but try and remember exactly what's at stake here. You need to get together, kid. Running out of
right.
time.
That was unusual. Well, I'm just gonna pretend that this never happened and get back to bringing everyone up to speed on where we stand. The news isn't good. It appears this temple is powered by a collection of, well, I guess they're batteries. You found one on your way in, but there aren't any more, at least not down here.
Any idea on where we can find replacements?
Not yet, so I intend to tiptoe into the Abstergo database. Now, if I can cross-reference these particular devices with their database, then maybe we'll get lucky.
See what you can do.
Obviously. Anyway, Desmond, you can either take a look around here or we can head back to the Animus.
All right, here goes.
Welcome back, Desmond. You'll be happy to hear there's actually good news for once.
Yeah?
I've managed to locate a power source, and it's relatively close by. Up for a trip to Manhattan?
Is it safe to leave? Abstergo's gotta be looking for us.
Obviously it's not safe. Can't exactly sit around here hoping to get lucky, though, can we? We need that power source. Besides, I'm sure you can cook up some way to hide our movements.
Maybe. The Templars have access to all kinds of satellites and camera systems. We'll need to find a way to mask our digital signature. I can probably camouflage the van, too. But there's not much I can do for us.
That's an easy one.
Local utility companies have assured the public that they're completely prepared for the upcoming solar maximum. Disruptions to service are expected to be minimal.
If only they knew.
What's this?
A remote-operated camera. It'll provide us with a feed while you're on mission. This will let us talk to each other.
We're almost there, so listen up. The artifact is in an office penthouse in Lower Manhattan. At this time of night, direct infiltration is going to get you noticed. I think we're better off having you drop in from above.
What do you mean, above? Testing, 1, 2, 3.
Yep, reach you just fine. Now why don't you power up the camera? I've got pictures. Running diagnostics. Perfect. I've got a nice, strong signal. Jump when you're ready, but wait for my signal to open the chute. Timing's really important here. Too soon or too late, and you'll miss the building.
Wasn't so bad.
So, you must be Desmond. Not exactly what I expected, but I guess your kind doesn't have many options these days.
Who are you?
Ask your father. Now give me that.
I don't think so.
Look, I'm not supposed to kill you, but the boss man didn't say anything about fucking you up. So you got to the counter.
So who the hell is Daniel Cross?
Believe it or not, he used to be an assassin. The assassin, the way I've heard it told, but it turned out he was a sleeper agent for Abstergo, programmed to infiltrate and destroy the organization.
How did he know you were there? We could be compromised.
They must have caught me snooping inside their network and sent Cross to see what we were after. If they were aware of our current location, we'd know. Though, I will say this, it doesn't bode very well for future expeditions.
I've set up some cameras topside. If anyone shows up, we'll see it.
I'd suggest you go see about finding a socket for that power source. Or we can return to Connor if you prefer. All the artifacts in the world won't mean a thing without the key.
Thought we could be saved. We sought to face the sun's wrath and contain it. Four towers would be built to pull her fury into this place and dispel it. But even with all we knew, with all we had, it would take too long. 1,000 years we could labor and still the work would not be done. The first tower was never completed. The project abandoned. We moved on. But while we labored on other endeavors, a few returned. They thought to automate the process. Metal might finish what flesh could not. If we could not meet the sun's cruel embrace, perhaps we might rebuke it. Already we could generate the fields to protect us in times of strife. But these were small and simple things. To replicate them on a scale the size of a world, we lack the energy to make it so. Half the world, they said then. It is better than none at all. We tried. Again, we failed. A quarter, they asked. Even this we could not do. A sixth, an eighth, a tenth, they cried. The answer was still the same. Perhaps in time a city might be spared. But it was time we did not have. So we moved on.
Wonder what's inside.
Only one way to find out.
Good luck, Desmond.
Everything all right?
Sean has located a second power source. I've asked Rebecca to charter a flight for us.
Where to?
Brazil.
Rebecca?
Bad reception. Can you hear me?
Well, glad to see that's working. Guess I'll try you back when I'm topside. You copy now?
Loud and clear.
What's the plan?
According to our intel, the power source is being worn as a bracelet by some tycoon's trophy wife. We're working on pinpointing her location, but she's most likely inside a VIP booth on the stadium's upper level. I'll update you when I know more.
Now to find a ticket.
We don't have time to play nice. Steal someone else's.
Bit of a dick move, don't you think?
Well, I guess you could try and sneak past security instead.
We can get back to Connor whenever you're ready, Desmond. Unless you want to plug in the power source first. Up to you.
What is a fact? Is it fixed? Immutable? Certain in its existence and only awaiting discovery? Or might it be changed? Here we learned the answer and thought that it might save us. They were used to command, to control, to own. But we soon discovered another use. When enough sat enthralled and were told to believe, their thoughts took on form. What we imagined became real. If 100 minds could wish away a wall or create a tree, what might 1,000 do? 10,000? More? Might we change the consensus and will the threat away? We resolve to send one into the sky where it might illuminate us all. Once placed, a sentence would be uttered. Make us safe. In this way, we would change the consensus. We would save the world. But it never came to be. We sent a dozen of them skyward, but there was no way to maintain control, to direct the beam, to enthrall the world, to speak the words. Though this was strange and dangerous, what we tried next was worse. Our first instinct was to travel back, to change the past. But we could not find a way. But forward, we could look forward. And so here we sought to see beyond ourselves and know what was to come. First, we watched to learn if our work would succeed. But the answer was always the same. So we moved on to other things, but she remained. The one you call Minerva. In time, she too stopped looking, and instead began to speak. She called out across time, in the hopes that you might be saved. She hid messages where none might find them, save for you and those within this place.
Fascinating.
Tired of it. The cryptic warnings, the threats. Just tell us what you want!
But they are. We saw the Nephilim there. We seemed like grasshoppers in our own eyes, and we looked the same to them. Imagine trying to explain all this to a 2-year-old, to a grasshopper. When they said the will of the gods was unknowable, they meant it. Literally.
I killed her, you know. I killed Lucy.
It was the apple, son. It was Juno.
I saw what she was. What would happen if I let her live? I could have stopped myself. I mean, there was a force there. But I didn't have to. I chose to.
Desmond.
Lucy was going to betray us and take the apple back to Abstergo. I saw the satellite launched. I saw them turn it on, and then it failed. Whatever's on the other side of that door, it benefits Juno. We need to be careful. I wonder what stories the temple will tell me today.
I'm telling you, there's something down here.
Don't be daft.
I don't know. Maybe they were sleeping or something and we woke them. Some kind of cryogenics? Or hibernation? I mean, how do we know what the hell they were doing down here?
They were working on a bunch of different solutions, but nothing worked. Just went from one to the next, and then I don't know. They must have left at some point. After the end.
I wonder what the world would be like if they'd succeeded.
I'm more concerned about what it'll be like if we don't.
Salvation. They found a way. Too late for them, but not for you. Sealed to protect it. Though now it bars your way. Find the key. The past will tell.
Oh, look at that. I found a third power source.
Already?
It popped up in an earlier search, but I've only just managed to confirm it.
Where?
There's a museum in Cairo with one on display.
I guess Connor will have to wait.
No, you stay. We need to find that key, and time is running out. I'll make the trip.
What about Cross?
Everything's going to be fine. I'll be back soon.
Ready when you are, Desmond. Something's happened, Desmond. Abstergo has your dad.
Where?
Italy. Same place they were holding you.
What are you two waiting for? Let's go.
There's more.
Hello again, Mr. Miles. I hope this message finds you well, or as well as it can, all things considered. It appears we now each have something the other desires. I propose a trade. Bring me the apple, and I'll return your father to you no worse for the wear. Should you refuse, he will still be returned, albeit much worse for the wear. I assume you'd like to avoid an unpleasant outcome.
I always knew it would come to this. Just not so soon. I wonder if Abstergo even knows what's about to happen. And has this been a part of their plan all along? Maybe they want the world to end. To see it all burned away. Then they'd have their new world, ripe for the reshaping. We talked about looking for another power source, leaving him there. It's probably what he'd want, for us to finish the mission. But I can't. It's hard enough taking a life, but letting one be taken? Knowing there was something I could do about it? Not a chance. Might be I'm risking my life, risking all our lives to save an asshole. What else am I supposed to do? That asshole is my dad.
They're probably holding your father on the upper levels, same place they kept you. There's an elevator bank down the hall. Try not to let them see you.
They know I'm here, Rebecca. There's no way they don't.
This was a bad idea.
Hand over your weapons and come with me, sir.
I can show myself in, but thanks for the offer.
I'd rather this not turn ugly, Mr. Miles.
Then let me through.
Subdue the subject, please.
Fourth floor.
Walking into an elevator in the middle of a hostile environment. Really?
Where's my father?
You'll see him soon enough. Now be a good boy and wait for security to fetch you.
You're gonna have to climb the rest of the way.
Give me the apple. Let's not draw this out. You got nowhere to go, and I've got a gun. Speaking of which, it's the 21st century, and you're still running around with only a tiny knife for protection? It's stupid. All right, Desmond. Game's over. Not now. Not now. Inya is just a robot. Yet. Get out!
What the hell was that?
Get out! Get out! Get out!
Where's Vidic?
Vidic's office is up ahead.
Not so fast, Mr. Miles. In case you hadn't noticed, I'm the one calling the shots. Now give me the apple.
You want it? Fine. Here it is.
Wait! No!
You never should have come here. You put everything on the line. For what? So you could rescue your father?
Yeah.
I'd get the power source hooked up before heading back into the Animus. But it's your call.
A new world approached. One that was dark and cold. It would consume us. For we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice. Not to save us all. So we sought to change what we were. In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita, my husband, my love. In the end, it changed him, ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive. But his mind became brittle to the touch. He begged me for release, for days, for weeks, for months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us. Consciousness but a series of electrical impulses, and the body a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles into dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced with something stronger, something better? So we forged a new vessel, one that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered, though. Were they right to turn away?
Home stretch, Desmond. I can feel it.
I know where the key is.
Then let's go!
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Moment of truth.
come. Here, at last.
You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not touch the pedestal.
Minerva?
You.
But how? You left! You destroyed the device! Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
Free her?
Juno dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion. Divination through numbers. There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time. This was my focus. And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned it towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we put a stop to it. And then we left. But first we called to you, that you might try again. We thought it would be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinia and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place and finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries, and so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying!
Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved. Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that so? Show him then.
But he will not understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world. Merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows. Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. You will inspire them to rebuild, to thrive once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man, frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. You will be remembered first as a hero, later as a legend, and in time, as a god. It is the cruelest fate to have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better? She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future. But it's freedom?
What future? What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew? This world has known nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them. And you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it.
But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
If you free her, you'll be destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't.
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us. We'll find another way.
There isn't time.
Son.
You know it's true. It's already started. I need to do this now. So go. Go!
Electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for... Geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... on record. Satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and... seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's event. But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... now it's time that I played mine.